What's up, guys? This is Matthias, and today we are going to create, save, and link custom preflop spots. So I want to take a look at small blind facing a big blind free bet. So in order to set this up, we are going to practice. We are going to preflop because it's just easier if we are setting up all the bubbles by using this mode. So we are facing the small versus big blind free bet. And as you can see, the board is now set up. And if we now go to custom, we don't have to set up all the players by hand. Pot size, we leave empty. If there were antes, we can set the pot size to the ante. And board, we also leave empty, given that it's a preflop situation. So let's go ahead to Monka Solver. And this is the facing free bet for the sim. So we are going ahead and copy the fold on the call and the raise. So nothing new here. Paste it in here and go to generate. Don't need Monka Solver anymore. And that's pretty much it. Now we can already go ahead and practice, and we can also go ahead and save. So this is 100 big blind, it's versus free bet, and the file name, you can see here the structure, it's preflop 100 BB versus free bet. We are in the small blind, and the file name, yeah, I just, that's the suggestion that you just call it versus MP, or in this case versus big blind. Don't need a comment. Maybe if there was some exploitive sim or there were limpers in the hand that you can't really see, you can put it in the comment. So yeah, we save it for now. And now I already have the link icon. This is because I already set up the raise first in for the small blind before the video. So as you can see here, we have for the raise first in, we have set up a cutoff and the small blind. That's why we are already seeing the linking icon. So setting up the small blind is pretty much exactly the same. And yeah, go ahead and click the link. We get suggested the right spot and set as parent. So this way, now if we are going to call here, we can go back to the parent. And I've already set up some other sims for this situation. So I linked not only the raising, as you can see here, this is the one we have currently set up. So if raise is the correct answer, we get directed forward to the versus free bet spot. And we can answer the question here. Going back to the parent. Yeah, here, for example, we have king 9-4-3. I think it's pretty clear that this is a fold. So if I know a hand is pretty clear in either direction, I can click on the hand and set up different versions of this hand. So I can have, for example, the double suited version, and maybe this is then limp. I don't think so. And as we can see, yeah, no version of this hand is an open raise. And yeah, we can go ahead and do this for as many hands as we want. Let's see. I still think it's a fold, and yeah, it is. But yeah, just to remind you that this feature is existing. And for example, here the double suited version I think is playable. So maybe let's go ahead with the call. And yeah, the call is correct. And now we can continue to the situation I have set up and linked to the versus call. To the limp, when limp is the correct answer, or the complete rather. And this is the versus raise. So now we limped and faced the raise. And I guess this is a limp call and it's correct. So what we can do now is find a hand that might be limp raising. Maybe this one. Let's see. Yeah, this is limp raising. And I've already set up or linked this sim to a versus four bet sim. So if we are raising and facing the four bet, we can also check what to do here. And let's go for the call, and the call is correct. So just that you can see, there is also multiple linking possible. So you first had the limp, then you had the limp versus raise, then had the limp raise versus the raise four bet. So yeah, you can do a lot of stuff here. I also want to show you how multiple lines as a continue work. So let's open up Preflop 100pp and let's go with the cutoff setup. So let's load up the cutoff race first in and let's go ahead and find, okay, this is already an open race. Let's continue. And as you can see, I have set up now a versus free bet situation. I have set up versus squeeze situation and I have set up a cold four bet situation. So we can pick either of them. Keep in mind that there is not versus button free bet versus small blind free bet versus big blind free bet. Simply because if you just imagine you're under the gun and you have like five versus three bet spots, you have four versus cold four bet spots, you have a lot of versus squeeze spots. So this would be all the buttons, not very clear to see. So what we decided to do is that we just decide what do we want to face. Let's see, we want to face a free bet and then we get a random free bet. So in this case, it's the big blind. And yeah, let's say we are calling here in position. And if you're wondering, but what to do versus an in position free bet, we have this icon here where we can iterate through all the child sims we have linked. So this would iterate now through all the free bet spots we have linked. So clicking here once, we can see now the small one is free betting. I guess this is not making a difference. But if we click again, we can see we get the one where the button is free betting. And here, I think this should be rather a fold, but no, it's still a call. So yeah, but you get the point. Here we can compare different scenarios. And if we want to go back to the parent, we go back to the parent. And this is pretty much the same here with the clicking on the board. This is also possible for practice mode. So for example, let's see what the triple suits are doing. Yeah. Close open race, and here we can go ahead and continue versus squeeze. So we created this situation, linked it to the cutoff race first in, and now we can see what to do here. Fold is correct. What is if we have a different squeeze situation? I mean, here we are folding even more. These are the two squeeze situations we have set up, and yeah. Also, maybe in case you didn't know, we also have this hand filter. So what you can do with this is you can filter, let's say, let's go to double pairs and single suited. And if we are now going to click on filter, you can see what this exact category is doing. So it will now filter for single to the double pairs, and you can see, okay, some of them are, there's a small range of them that is four betting, but most of them are calling. We have no folds. And yeah, you can play around here, going to double suited, refresh, and we can see it's pretty much the same. So yeah, different scenarios, maybe go with middle and low pairs, double suited. And yeah, so yeah, here you can play around and see what different types of hands are doing. And if you go to new hand, you are getting exactly these type of hands you selected on the left generated.